Over 2,000 years ago, the Apostle Paul strolls into what was then the New Corinth, a rebuilt Roman city only 100 years old in its day. Roughly the size of Fort Worth, Texas, this city was full of cultural diversities, pagan worship, idolatry, power, and wealth, but a city made famous for its sin, especially its sexual sin. Historians compare the New Corinth to the modern-day San Francisco. A city in where most Christians would have continued to pass through, Paul does just the polar opposite, as he literally goes into the midst of the sin and says, this here, in the midst of everything going on here, I'm going to build God's church. And with the help of some others that come alongside him, he does just that, and the Corinthian church is birthed. Throughout all of Paul's missionary journeys, the Corinthian church ends up being the largest church in number, but quickly becomes his most problematic church, as they quickly find themselves adapting to the sinful world that's going on around them. Paul actually writes three letters to the Corinthian church. The first one was lost throughout history. The second letter that we call 1 Corinthians was actually his second letter to this church in a desperate attempt to get them to turn from their ways and back to the foundation that he had laid out before them years prior. One of the similar problems that we have in our churches today is that we, like the Corinthian church, have found ourselves fall into the same problem of a society saying we don't need your cross, we don't need your forgiveness, we don't need your grace, we don't need your Jesus, and we water down the gospel. And our churches are full, our youth groups are full of people that say that they believe in God, that they're Christians, but at the end of the day, they act like everybody else. And over the next 8 months, we're going to look into this letter written by Paul, and we're going to see how can we apply this to our lives today. I mean, at the end of the day, can we be a generation to go and make much of Jesus, and whatever that looks like, so that we can be a generation much like the one that Paul was spurring this Corinthian church to be, to go and make much of Jesus. I hope you can join us for this unbelievable journey, this amazing letter of grace and mercy, a letter of forgiveness, a letter of compassion, but more than that, a letter of hope. A hope that no matter where we're at in our walks with Jesus, man, maybe you come into this study and you don't know Christ at all. Maybe you come in here and you used to be like the Corinthian church. You were fired up for a gospel, but somewhere along the way you've fallen. Somewhere along the way you let sin entangle you, and you spend more time trying to fill in the blanks of why God would never use you instead of being back to what he called you to be all about. What happens when we step out of that and get back to what Christ called us to be all about? Get that relationship that's there waiting for us, pulled together as a body of believers, and go and make much of the name of Jesus, not only in Grandview, but in a world, a dark and dying world that needs Jesus more than ever. Hope you can join us.